This tutorial is part of our practical database design course. You can find a link to the YouTube playlist for this course in the video description. Alternatively, if you like this course, you can watch the complete course uninterrupted, ad-free, access updated tutorials and download the source code and more from our Udemy course. Again, the link to the course is in the video description. Hopefully you watched the previous tutorials and you're totally on board with what an entity is and the fact that a database would be empty without them. In this tutorial, I want to move us or inch us forward towards starting our project, building a database for our blog application scenario. So our first step in the design process will be to analyze, determine, establish our significant entities. But why the emphasis on significant? Well, as we move through the design process, we may generate other entities, which we will use to further improve our database design. These entities that we generate through the design process, we won't necessarily have identified them at the start of the design process. Therefore, we start by establishing significant entities. So let's imagine we're building a database to store student information and course data. What might be the significant entities here? Remember, entities are tables. So what tables might we need? What entities might we need for this type of system? Or we might generate a student table. If we're going to be storing information about the student, we're going to need a student table. If the students are on a course, well, course is something we want to model that we need to store information about. It has attributes, so therefore course. And of course, these courses might be connected to categories. So again, that is not necessarily the most concrete entity that you might have thought about, but it is something we want to store information about, the different types of categories, potentially the category name. So that might potentially also be an entity. So let's now imagine that we had, for example, a scenario where we were building a database for a company who wanted to record information about their car wash business. So what entities might be needed? What significant entities might we generate for that based upon that information? Well, okay, so this is a car washing company. We want to record information about maybe what cars have been washed. So potentially we need to store information about the car. So we'd have a car table. Maybe we have customers because this business will be working with customers. So we may need to store information about the customer as well as their car. And in addition to that, this is a company. So we are having to store information about our employees because we potentially need to use that information to conduct our business in some way. So we may have some sort of employee table. So sometimes it can be fairly easy to, in some scenarios, maybe again in an educational setting, for us to easily identify some of the significant entities. And although we can take this step at the start, it doesn't necessarily mean that these tables will be realized. Of course, this will all be dependent upon your requirements, upon your specifications, but it can be a good start to think this way. Actually, identify some entities before you then fully read the documentation, just to get us started. So we can do the same thing. The last example, maybe an e-commerce system. So if I just told you, okay, we're going to build an e-commerce system for products, well, that means we're going to need a product table. That potentially means that we're going to be working with customers. That means we're going to need to store information about sales. Now, of course, it won't always be as apparent as I'm making it out to be, but I'm just trying to get you into the general idea of identifying entities or these significant entities. In reality, it can be tricky to extract information from any documentation you may have to support the process of determining the entities for our new database. At this first stage of identifying entities, needless to say, it's always best to have all the information before you start this process. So collecting any specifications, any requirements, any scenarios or case studies that you're working with, just get all the information together. Make sure you have everything before you start building and identifying those entities and attributes. In addition to that, you may have to take some additional tasks or perform some additional tasks. Again, this is going to be dependent upon your particular setting, but generally you might then create some different meetings to discuss different entities that you've identified with different stakeholders and such. You may undertake interviews with employees, for example, to really determine the type of data that they're working with or customers, what type of data they need, and then potentially analyzing existing systems and services. So maybe you're not building a completely new database. Maybe you're just refactoring, or you're generating a similar service or updating the service. So understanding what exists already will obviously be key to that process. So once you have all this information to hand, that's when I guess the real work starts to begin. If the requirement stage has been completed successfully, I would expect to find documentation that would lead to a smoother process of getting started building a list of entities and associated attributes. Of course, that might not always be the case. If you are working from an assignment brief, a scenario or case study, you best start by classifying what a noun is. So that's always a good start. So what we're looking for here is entities typically are going to be nouns. So if you are working again with a case study, for example, first of all, classifying what a noun is, really kind of getting that into your mind, is going to help. And then with that information, you can then start to work through your brief or case study, identifying these nouns, so student, product, and so on. Again, you might need to read through a few times, at least to get a start or a better understanding of your scenario. Something you can also do is kind of work backwards. Sometimes it can be easier to identify attributes rather than the actual entities. And then by understanding the attributes or identifying your attributes, you can then determine your entities. Another good place to start, again, I guess this is more of an educational context, is find existing services and examples. I think that from my experience, students don't do this enough. You're given a scenario, the likelihood is that isn't unique. It's been done before, or it already exists. So try and seek out that information, and you can really learn a lot from having a look at other services. Although you can't see their database, you can look at their service, have a look at their terminology, have a look at the services that they provide. And that's going to help you and give you information about names and features and insights, which will help you or inspire you to generate those entities and attributes to start your design process. Because I've not said it enough, entities represent objects in the real world. Let's not forget that. So let's search for nouns. That can be a good place to start. Again, more of an educational setting here, but go through your documentation, search for nouns. That can be a good start to identify the entities. Now remember, they can be physical or conceptual. So the conceptual aren't necessarily always obvious. So maybe you look for the physical, more obvious entities first, establish those entities which are going to be critical for that particular service, product, car, like we've discussed, and then you can kind of work from there. If you're still finding it hard to identify entities, think about some of the attributes that might need to be stored, or try and extract the attributes, and then from the attributes, you can potentially identify the entities. And then finally, what I haven't included here, remember that if you are, again, in an educational setting, the likelihood is that thing that you're trying to design already exists. So try and search it out. Try and find it. Try and find information which will help you then generate and start your process.